from Rotten Tomatoes. If you're the kind of horror nerd whose cage gets especially rattled by seances, shock scares, and the supernatural, you're in for a hell of a time. Movies like Heredity don't come around often enough. That's sadly due to the fact that audiences usually don't flock out to see films that look abstract. This goes on for a long time. Look what I found. Heredity, let's do it. First, I don't know if I've reviewed a horror film. I think I maybe talked about them a couple times, but I'm a horror movie fan, and I'm not like the jump scare horror movie. I like psychological, you know, kind of tripped out horror films and this. With that being said, I knew going into this, it's an A24 flick. A24 is not known for being clear. That somebody said in the reviews that, oh, it's abstract. Like, I get that. I get abstract. But here's the thing. This movie... First of all, let me go into some things that I did, some things that I can like and respect about this movie. It shot beautifully. Things are framed really interestingly. So the mother in this movie, Toni Collette, she, from the very beginning, she makes miniatures, but she makes these very intricate, ornate models. So you'll see things at the very beginning, it zooms into this model. And then throughout the movie, you kind of realize, oh, it looks kind of like they're framing things. Like it's a model. There's a metaphor in there, I'm sure. Maybe we're all in a house of our own building. I don't know. I don't do metaphors very well. So there were some interesting, you know, framing choices and, you know, shot choices where, like, if I was standing like this, you'd expect something to come in over here, but then maybe something doesn't. So it kind of puts you on edge and puts you, you know, so that was cool. I can get on board with that. You know, put the candle at a funky angle or hang on something a little bit too long to make me think something. Like, I'm for that. Mess with me. I like that. I like being messed with. I will say, you know, Toni Collette's performance was great. The other performances in the movie were passable. The son, whose name is Peter, Alex Wolf, he put on a pretty damn good performance. I'll give him that. So the performances were pretty good, but here's the thing. The story itself, I get that it's abstract and I get that, you know, you're supposed to think about it. What ultimately this movie suffers from is the fact that you get that there's something, you know, in the daughter's head, there's something in here that is some messed up part of heredity, you know, that's going from person to person. So you get that there's something going on. But the fact of the matter is, by about a third of the way through the movie, the whole reason I should give a crap about whatever that is completely disappeared from me. It was just gone. Like, I went, all right, why am I even watching this movie now? Something happens. I don't want to spoil it, but something happens that makes me go, oh, that I didn't, I thought I was coming to watch this, but apparently I'm watching something else. And then in the very last, like, 5 minutes of the movie just takes a real hard turn in a direction that the conclusion of everything that happens didn't make me care about what was going on up here in the characters. I really just went, that's what I was waiting for. That reveal was garbage. I could care less. So the fact is, the ending was so brutally weak for me that I just didn't, it made me really, there was no payoff. The payoff at the end of the movie that all these things I thought I was waiting for throughout the film just didn't happen. So therefore, all these times when something was framed like this and there was a number in the background that I'm like, oh, should I be paying attention to that? Nope, never came up again. Or this one creepy dude that's at one point in the movie, when he does show up again, I'm like, that's why he was there? The whole, okay. So the fact is that performance is great. You know, shots and framings, great. Story idea, really cool. Execution just didn't care, which is too bad, because the thing is that there were, now wait, let me back it up really quick. When it comes to like the scares and some of those things in the movie, kudos about 90%, because there would be times something happened, there was not a jump scare. It was like a slow burn. Did I just see what I think I see? And there would be times I'd be sitting in the theater watching and I could hear people around me going, and I'm just watching going, what? And then slowly I realized what someone's seeing, you know, and I was like, what? Okay, those were very cool. One point in particular, one of the kind of creepiest moments in the movie, my theater burst out laughing at a point that was supposed to be the really creepy, scary part. People just started busting up laughing just because the way it was shot just was comical. A24 independent, not like a huge effects budget, and I don't need crazy effects in a horror movie. One of the effects towards the very end, it's supposed to be like this levitation was so laughably ridiculous. It took me out of it. I'm really sorry to rip this apart. I really am. And the thing is, all I'm ripping apart is the story, because I really don't care. When it hit the end and I went, okay, I don't care. I probably said I don't care about 15 times. Sorry. My scale is, you know, changing all the time. But it basically goes from like Golden Ticket here to Dumpster Fire down here. I can't throw it all the way down here, because I also get that I am not, maybe not the key audience for this movie. So here's what I'm going to suggest. Go to see it either in a matinee or a cheap matinee, or wait till it's on Netflix. Like, when the movie comes to that theater where like the movies go to after they've been out and it costs like $4 to go to that theater and see it. If you want to go see a better movie, throw a dart, in my opinion. You know, for people who really, really thought like, you know, It Comes at Night was an amazing movie, you'll like this movie. If you saw like The Insidious, you know, and you thought Insidious was an awesome horror flick, you're probably not gonna dig this, in my opinion. So if you like this review, let me know in the comments. If you didn't like the review, you think I totally missed the mark, please put it in the comments. I love talking about this stuff. Thanks so much for watching, and until next time, bye-bye.